So here it is at last, Uncharted 4. The game we've all been waiting for so long. The next competitive game for Sons of Chaos. Snake will be happy. The game, well, this is my third match, the gameplay you're seeing right now. One of the best matches I've ever played. Even though it started bad, I did so good that I actually like immediately went off this game and just started recording my commentary right now. So after a couple of hours of playing on camp of campaign, which is just fantastic, I just couldn't stop playing it to try out the multiplayer. I finally did it. So they have something called warm-up space. Three games, you have to play three games before you go anywhere else. Just like here, this is my third warm-up game. You can try yourself out against, newbies to see how it is like to shoot and all that. There are those trials, so you can get some like in-game currency to unlock stuff. But honestly, I think customization in this game is kind of downgraded since Uncharted 3, because we only have few characters, those villains and heroes, and they only can be customized. They have preset skins. Some of them are nice, but it's not it, just not it. In Uncharted 3 you could make your own villain or hero and customize them with tons of gear sets, even voices and faces. I remember I bought a lot of those silly customization things because they look cool, and they added actually some statistics to that, so that's different. And here you only have few characters which you can just upgrade with few hats, like face wear, clothes, and that's it. Like, there's nothing more to it. But this is like only one downside I've met so far. The gameplay is beautiful. Like, after going from campaign, which I've had locked on 30 FPS, I believe, I went into multiplayer and it just stunned me. 60 FPS, no stutter, frame issues, no nothing. Everything is smooth. Maybe you can see it right now on the video. I don't know if you can, see the difference. But this shit is so good. Like, it's 5 in the morning, probably will be, after I upload this video. And I can't keep myself from playing this game. It's addicting as hell. And I've been only playing Team Deathmatch. I have yet to try out the domination and the capture the flag mode, which I'm sure they are going to be fun, and the ranked playlist. Unfortunately, it's Team Deathmatch only. Thank God we have Fragged Nation and all that. Weapon-wise, the game is nice. Like, we have few automatic rifles, few semi-automatic sniper-like rifles, few SMGs, nice pistols. Nothing is too overpowered. Everything seems balanced and all. But we have those new sidekicks. They are not overpowered. They are just annoying. Maybe except Sniper, because she can kill you in one hit, but that's it. Like, the Brute is so slow that you can just run away from the place he was placed, and he's not that hard to kill. So that's nice. Then we have the Healer. He just heals and shoots with a pistol, nothing more to it. And the Hunter, which, if you played cooperation mode in Uncharted 3, he grabs you and just stuns you instantly so an enemy team can kill you. And that's it. They don't have too much health, they're easy to kill, you can see them on the radar. But still, they are bad. Then we have those mystical abilities. Every single one of them should be banned immediately in comp, and I hope they will be, because who wants like this Eldorado stuff in the game? There's also Cincinnati's Stone, which instantly heals everyone in close area. Then we have Power of Jhin, which allows you to like teleport. Stupid shit. Then we have something like Radar. It's not bad. It's actually one of those passive abilities. It just places everyone on the radar, so it's not that bad. And I believe there is some kind of stasis field that slows enemies. It's tactical, but still, it shouldn't be in the game, I think. And that's it for the mysticals, I believe. Heavy weapons. I always hated this shit because like it's always one hit kill, maybe except the pistol, and they have two fucking tubes, like China Lake, Noob Tube, and RPG. Sucks. Then we have like super shotgun, one hit kill, revolver, I think sniper rifle, I don't really remember. And that's it. Like, I think the Uncharted multiplayer is now bare bones, and they will start adding stuff like maybe later. Because really, I am so sad they didn't include the customizable, characters like they were in Uncharted 3. But that's it. That's it. Everything is fine. So far, so good. We will see what the future will show us. Because I don't. F if this is how the game will look like for the next few years, then I might be a little disappointed. Because Uncharted 3 was a bit better. Like, they even had that co-op mode, missions and all that. This game doesn't. So, like, right now, game is worth buying for those competitive players, like me, my team. But that's it. Like, that's it. So, I think I'll have fun on that. So, if someone is like thinking about buying this game for multiplayer, competitive stuff, then it's actually worth taking. Because PUB, you will just stop playing it after a few weeks, months, maybe. Because there is not really that much into this. But campaign-wise, you'll be like taken to the next step of heaven. You'll love it. I guarantee you that. That'll be it. My honest opinion on Uncharted 4, A Thief's End. I strongly recommend this game, just so you know. I like it, and I think like third-person like players will love it as well. So go grab it. And never regret doing it. Goodbye.